ஜய மாதவ குஞ்ச பிஹாரி ஜய மாதவ குஞ்ச பிஹாரி கோபி ஜானி பரதாஹி யசோதனந்தனப்ரஜஜனரஞ்சனா யமுனீராஜி ஜானி கோபி ஜானி ஹரே கிருஷ்ணா கிருஷ்ண கிருஷ்ணா ஹரே 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 ராம ஹரே ராம 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 ஹரே ஹரே
வசுதேவாய
நமோ பகவதே Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Vaishnavibhyo namo namah. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda. Shri Advaita Gadadhara Srivasade Gaurabhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
So, we are celebrating the Julan Yatra, which began, this is the fourth day of Julan Yatra, and tomorrow will be the final day of the Julan Yatra. Tomorrow, of course, is the appearance day of Lord Balaram. So traditionally, the Julan Yatra finishes tomorrow evening. As we all know, it's very hot at this time of the year, and especially in Vrindavan, it's very, very hot at this time. And in order to get some relief from the heat, the gopis arranged a wonderful swing for Radha and Krishna. So seeing the divine couple of Sri Sri, the gopis took pleasure in pushing the swing, and in this way Radha and Krishna are swinging back and forth, and they experience the cool breeze generated by the So every day we're singing Gajaya Radha Madhava Punjabi Hari. We're singing all glories to the pastimes of Radha and Krishna in the forests of Vrindavan. So we may wonder, what are these pastimes which are taking place in the forest? This is one of the pastimes which takes place. So Julan means the swing, and the swing is meant for the pleasure of Radha and Krishna, and all the devotees take pleasure in pushing the swing and giving pleasure to Radha and Krishna. We see in Braja, at different seasons, there are different kinds of festivals taking place according to the season.
வருடத்தில் ஒவ்வொரு காலத்திலும் குறிப்பிட்ட ஒவ்வொரு விழாவினை கொண்டாடுவது வழக்கம்.
Sometimes it's a flower festival, and many, many flowers will be brought, and we'll perform pushpa abhishek. We'll bathe the deities, we'll cover the deities with many different flowers. And sometimes we celebrate Govardhan Puja in the month of Kartik. The auspicious Govardhan Puja festival is celebrated, and at that time different foodstuffs will be offered according to that season.
Kartik madathil naam Govardhan Pujai nadathirukkom. Palavaiyana unavu padarthangal appozhudhu parimaarapadum andha kaalathirkkendravaadhu.
Sometimes the season is cold, and there will be a different kind of festival offered for the couple. But at this time of the year, it's very hot, and the couple enjoy to be seated on the swing, and the devotees enjoy pushing the swing, giving pleasure to Radha and Govinda. So you can see, we don't just worship only Krishna, but we worship Radha and Krishna. Krishna is never alone. He's always with either Srimati Radharani, or he's with Lord Balaram, or he's with Mother Yashoda, but he's never alone.
Krishna Bhagavani naam taniyaga valipaduvathu kidaiyadhu. Srimati Radharani udan, Sri Balaramar udan, alladhu Yashoda annayudan ivvaadhaan naam avarai valipadukkirom.
Before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared, usually it was only Krishna who was being worshipped. But it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who explained that actually Krishna alone is not complete, it's not proper, that Krishna should always be with his pleasure potency.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhuvin avadharathirkku munnal Krishna thaniyagathan valipadapattar anal Chaitanya Mahaprabhuvin bodhanai Krishna eppozhudhum thaniyaga irupadillai avarudaiya inba sakthiyudan thaan avar thondrugirar endru kurippidugirar.
Just like Lord Narsingadev is with his consort Lakshmi, or Lord Narayan is with Lakshmi, Lord Narsingadev is not different from Lord Narayan. He's an expansion of Vishnu, not different from Narayan.
அது போலவே நரசிம்மர் தோன்றும் பொழுது லட்சுமி தேவியுடன் தான் தோன்றுகின்றார். நரசிம்மர் என்பவர் ஸ்ரீமன் நாராயணன் அவதாரம். ஸ்ரீமன் நாராயணனும் லட்சுமி தேவியுடன் தான் வாசம் செய்கின்றார்.
And Lord Ramachandra is with his eternal consort Mother Sita.
அதே போல ஸ்ரீ ராமச்சந்திரமூர்த்தி அவர்களும் அவருடைய நித்திய தர்மபத்தினியான சீதா தேவியுடன் தான் இருக்கின்றார்.
Lord Shiva also comes with his consort Parvati.
அதே போல சிவபெருமானும் அவருடைய தர்மபத்தினி பார்வதி தேவியுடன் தான் இருக்கின்றார்.
So Lord Krishna is never alone. And to just simply worship Krishna on his own, Srila Prabhupada said, that is impersonal. Sometimes people have pictures of Krishna, and it's only Krishna with some light, some effulgence coming out from his body. So that is the impersonal aspect of Krishna.
சில சமயங்களில் கிருஷ்ண பகவான் தனியாக அவருடைய உடலை சுற்றிலும் பிரகாசம் தோன்றுவது போல் படங்களை நாம் காணலாம். இப்படிப்பட்ட தோற்றம் என்பது அவருடைய அறிவருவத்தை குறிக்கும்.
So it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who explained how Lord Krishna should be worshipped along with his pleasure potency Srimati Radharani. And then later on, the consort of Lord Nityananda, Janava, she began to place deities of Radharani beside the deity of Krishna.
இவ்வாறு சைத்தன்ய மகாபிரபு கிருஷ்ணரை எப்பொழுதும் அவருடைய இன்ப சக்தியோடுதான் வழிபட வேண்டும் என்று குறிப்பிட்டார்கள். அதன் பிறகு ஸ்ரீ நித்யானந்தரின் தர்மபத்தினியான ஜானகி தேவி மாதா அவர்கள் கிருஷ்ணருடன் இணைந்து ஸ்ரீமதி ராதாராணியை வழிபடும் வழக்க முறையை ஆரம்பித்து வைத்தார்கள்.
And she would go to different temples and she would arrange to place Srimati Radharani at the side of Lord Shri Krishna.
இவ்வாறு மற்ற ஆலயங்களுக்கெல்லாம் சென்று கிருஷ்ண பகவானின் பக்கத்தில் ஸ்ரீமதி ராதாராணியை பிரதிஷ்டை செய்தார்கள்.
Try to understand that the concept is we want to give pleasure to Radha and Krishna. We want to give pleasure to the Supreme Lord. Our duty is to give pleasure to them. We are the servants, they are the master.
இதன் நோக்கம் என்ன என்றால், இவர்களுக்கு இந்த உன்னத இளைஞருக்கு நாம் எப்பொழுதும் இன்பம் வழங்க வேண்டும். இவர்களுக்கு இன்பத்தை வழங்கி நாம் என்றென்றும் அவர்களின் சேவகர்களாக செயல்பட வேண்டும்.
In the material world, we are all conditioned souls. And the conditioned soul is thinking himself to be the enjoyer.
In the bhaudiya ulagil naam ellam kattunda aatmakal indha kattunda nilayil naam ellam nenikkirom naam dhaan anubhavippaalar endru.
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna explains there are two natures. There is daivi sampad and asurik sampad. Or there is the divine nature and there is the demoniac nature.
Bhagavad Gita Krishna Bhagavan deivika tanmayayum asura tanmayayum kurippidugirar.
In the demoniac nature we are thinking Ishwaraham, I am the controller. Ishwaraham, aham bhogi, I am the enjoyer. Siddoham, I am perfect. Balavam Sukhi, I am strong and I am happy.
Asura tanmayil oruvar avardhan usuravu anaitthukkum adhipathi anaithaiyum anubhavikkakoodiyavar ella aatralaiyum petravar endru karuvar.
In other words, the conditioned soul who is of the demonic nature is identifying with the material body and they're thinking only of the body as the self. They have not understood their real nature as spiritual souls.
இந்த அசுரத்தன்மையில் கட்டுண்ட ஆத்மா தனது உடலை தான் பிரமாணமாக கருதி கொண்டு அவர்தான் அனைத்தையும் கட்டுப்படுத்துபவர் என்ற மாயையில் இருக்கின்றார்.
So the Julanyatra festival is to bring us out of that bodily consciousness of life and to understand that there's a supreme being and we are not the supreme, but there is one supreme being and we are all his servants.
In the Julanyatra tribula kondadavan moolamaga naam namage udal thodarbana ulagilirundu vilagi parama purusha bhagavan dhaan unnada
Of all the servants of Lord Krishna, it is said that the gopis of Vrindavan, they were the greatest devotee, the greatest servants, because they sacrificed everything for the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
கோபிமார்கள் தான் மிக உயர்வாக கருதப்படுகின்றனர். ஏனென்றால் அவர்கள் பகவானின் இன்பத்திற்காக அனைத்தையும் துறந்தவர்கள்.
The materialistic person is only thinking about his own self. He's thinking about what I want. I want pleasure. Make Krishna happy, to give pleasure to Krishna.
பௌதிகவாதிகள் தன்னை பற்றியே சிந்திப்பார்கள், தனது இன்பத்தை பற்றியே சிந்திப்பார்கள். ஆனால் பகவானின் பக்தர்கள் பகவானுக்கு என்ன திருப்தி, எனது என்ன இன்பம் அளிக்கும் என்பதை பற்றி சிந்திப்பார்கள்.
So in this age, in this Kali Yuga, to please Krishna is very easy. We just simply have to chant his holy name. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has made it very easy for us to please Lord Krishna by teaching all of us to chant the holy name.
இந்த கலியுகத்தை பொறுத்தவரையில் கிருஷ்ண பகவானை பரிசுப்படுத்துவது மிக சுலபமானது. ஹரே கிருஷ்ண மகாமந்திரத்தின் ஜெபம் மூலமாக அவரை திருப்திப்படுத்த முடியும் என்ற இந்த வழிமுறையை ஸ்ரீ சைதன்ய மகாபிரபு
Lord Krishna is very pleased when the devotee chants his name. He has said that I am not in the spiritual world and I am not in the hearts of the yogis who meditate on me, but I am wherever my devotees like Narada are chanting my holy name.
நான் ஆன்மீக லோகத்தில் இல்லை, யோகிகளின் இதயத்திலும் இல்லை. எங்கெல்லாம் நாரதர் போன்ற பக்தர்கள் இருக்கின்றார்களோ அங்கேதான் நான் இருக்கின்றேன் என்று கூறுகின்றார்.
So it is said the holy name appears on the tongue of the devotee when we try to chant the name of the Lord. Krishna himself manifests in the form of his holy name. It is said, Kali Kale Namarupe Krishna Avatar, that in the Kali Yuga, Krishna comes in the form of his holy name. One devotee was asked by Srila Prabhupada to give a lecture on the chanting of the holy name. Srila Prabhupada was going to give initiation and he requested one of his senior devotees to give a lecture and explain about the chanting of the holy name. So the devotee was giving the lecture, and at one point he said, Krishna is in his name. But Srila Prabhupada interrupted and said, no, he said, Krishna is his name. So the devotee was making a mistake. He was distinguishing between Lord Krishna and Lord Krishna's name. But Prabhupada was pointing out that the name of Krishna is not different from Lord Krishna.
அந்த பக்தர் கிருஷ்ணருக்கும் அவருடைய நாமத்திற்கும் வேறுபாடு இருப்பதாக குறிப்பிட்ட பொழுது பிரபுமாதர் அவர்கள் இடைமறைத்து அவரை சரிப்படுத்தும் நோக்கத்தில் கிருஷ்ணருக்கும் அவருடைய நாமத்திற்கும் எந்த வேறுபாடும் கிடையாது.
When we chant the holy name of Lord Krishna, we have to be very careful to chant with proper care and attention and give full respect to the holy name.
Adanal
And you can see when we were performing the Jula Yatra, we had also kirtan. It's very important that when we are trying to do different services for the deities, that we also perform kirtan. We don't just simply pull the swing, but there must also be kirtan going on for the pleasure of Radha and Govinda. And similarly, when we offer aarti to the deities, there should also be kirtan taking place. Srila Prabhupada was very concerned that we would keep up the standards like this in all of our centers. I had experienced myself, I was in the temple in Vrindavan in the time of Srila Prabhupada. And Srila Prabhupada was staying in his house, which is behind the temple in Vrindavan. So I was there in the temple room at midday when the noon aarti took place. And there were not many people there. It was the early years of our temple. There were not big crowds coming in Vrindavan at that time. So I took the kartals and I began to lead the kirtan. We were having some kirtan. But after 5 minutes, Prabhupada's secretary came out from his room from behind the temple and he said, Srila Prabhupada wants to know, why is nobody playing the madanga? And Srila Prabhupada had told the secretary, whenever there is kirtan and aarti, there should be kirtan with madanga and kartals. Both should be there. Srila Prabhupada was very particular about these things and he took great care to instruct us in how to keep up the standards of devotion for the pleasure of Radha and Govinda. So the Jula Yatra is another festival which we put on every year at this time, just simply to give pleasure to the couple, Radha and Govinda. And we encourage all of you that you can also arrange like that, you can worship Radha and Govinda. And if you don't have deities, you can do it in your mind. within your mind, you can also have the deity of Radha and Govinda. And within your mind, you can arrange a nice swing festival and give pleasure to Radha and Govinda.
You are in the lower world, and you are in the
The deity can be made of different elements. It can be brass, it can be stone, it can be jewels, it can be paint, it can also be in the mind. So no one has any excuse not to worship Radha and Govinda in this way. Hare Krishna. Any questions?
What's the reason the South Indians do not give prominence for the worship of Sri Sri Radha Krishna? They only worship Krishna in a single form and also the worship of Lakshmi Narayan. Why not Radha Krishna?
Well, I explained that it's wrong. Tonight I explained that you should worship Radha and Krishna. You should not just simply worship Krishna alone. Lord Krishna is never alone. He's always accompanied with either his pleasure potency, Srimati Radharani, or with his expansion, Lord Balarama, or with his own mother, Yashoda. But you never find Krishna alone.
நான் சற்று முன்பு இதற்கு விளக்கம் அளித்தேன். இவ்வாறு வழிபடுவது தவறான முறை என்று. கிருஷ்ண பகவானை எப்பொழுதும் தன்மையில் வழிபடக்கூடாது. அவருடைய பின்ப ஆற்றலான ஸ்ரீமதி ராதாராணி அல்லது அவரது தீவந்தமான ஸ்ரீ பலராமர் அல்லது அவரது சொந்த தாயாரான யசோதை அன்னையோடு அவரை வழிபட வேண்டும். தனிமையாக அல்ல.
So it's important that Lord Krishna should be there along with someone, not alone. Okay. Any other question? Any
other?
In Srila Prabhupada's time, was it celebrated? Yes? Oh yes. In Srila Prabhupada's time, we also had this. Srila Prabhupada introduced these events to us. And there were many other events which Srila Prabhupada introduced. Not all of them are being celebrated today. When the devotees when they purchased the temple in Los Angeles and they had a big place, then Srila Prabhupada was giving them instructions and they were having festivals every week. different festivals, sometimes churning butter and things like holy, you know, the, where they bathe, they have the boat festival, and they have the Pushpa Abhishek I mentioned. There's many different festivals which they celebrate.
உதாரணத்திற்கு வெண்ணெய் கடையும் திருவிழா, தெப்ப திருவிழா, இவ்வாறு ஒவ்வொரு வாரமும் திருவிழாக்கள் நடைபெற வேண்டும் என்று வலியுறுத்தியிருந்தார்கள்.
Different festivals for some in relation to the cows, and there's a festival where Krishna becomes older to go, he changes from taking care of calves, he will be taking care of cows, and different festivals like that.
என்பதை
பற்றி எல்லாம் திருவிழாக்கள் கொண்டாடுமாறு அவர் வலியுறுத்தியிருந்தார். You can have a festival.
வழக்கமாக ஒவ்வொரு நாளும்
நாம் திருவிழாக்கள் கொண்டாடலாம். We have Lord Jagannath here, the Lord is here, he's coming. Just you're not coming every day. You're missing the festival. But every day there's a festival. Hare Krishna. Yes? Hi, Shama.
But when the Freak has loved and combined, Lada and Krishna, Nagas Rotus,
no, Madhavendra Puri. She's saying Madhavendra Puri introduced the worship of Radha and Krishna. So she's saying, did he do it with deities? I said, no, didn't have deities. But he was in his meditation, he was worshipping Krishna in the mood of Raghabhava, in that mood of separation from Krishna, in the mood of the gopis. The mood of gopi, separation, feeling separation, that when will Krishna come? So Madhavendra Puri taught that mood in the worship of Lord Krishna. And that was what Lord Chaitanya took up, he followed that mood.
இந்த ராதாகிருஷ்ணர் வழிபாட்டை ஆரம்பித்து வைத்தவர் ஸ்ரீ மாதவேந்தர் புரி அவர்கள். அதற்கு மகாராஜ் அவர்களின் பதில், இல்லை, ஆனால் ஸ்ரீ மாதவேந்தர் புரி ராகபாவம், அதாவது பிரிவாற்றாமை, பகவானின் பிரிவை தாங்க முடியாத பாவத்தில் அவர் பகவானை வழிபட்டு வந்தார். இந்த வழிமுறையை தான் பிறகு பின்னாளில் ஸ்ரீ சைதன்ய மகாபிரபு அவர்களும் தொடர்ந்து வலியுறுத்தினார்.
And Madhavendra Puri, while he was leaving the body, then he was reciting a verse where he was saying that, oh, where are you now, O master of Mathura? Because of your not being present, my heart has become most disturbed. So he was lamenting in the separation from Krishna, because Krishna had gone off to Mathura, he'd left Vrindavan. So the gopis were feeling that pain of separation. So Madhavendra Puri cultivated that mood.
ஸ்ரீ மாதவேந்திரபுரிய அவர்கள் தனது உலகை விட்டு நீங்கும் பொழுது ஒரு பிரார்த்தனை செய்தார்கள். மதுரையின் நாயகனே, நீ எங்கே சென்று விட்டாய்? இவ்விடத்தில் நீ இல்லாமல் எனது மனம் அதிக சஞ்சலமடைகின்றது என்றெல்லாம் அவர் கலங்கினார்.
And Lord Chaitanya, he appreciated that mood and he took up that mood himself in his worship of Krishna.
இவ்வாறு இந்த ஸ்ரீ மாதவேந்திரபுரியின் பாவத்தை ஏற்றுதான் ஸ்ரீ சைதன்ய மகாபிரபு இதை நடைமுறைப்படுத்தினார்.
Lord Chaitanya would go to see Lord Jagannath. And when he would go to the Jagannath temple, he would only see Jagannath. And he would see Lord Jagannath as Gopi Jana Balava, as the flute player of Vrindavan.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Jagannath Puri ki sellum bolude, Jagannatharai eppadi kaanvaar endral, Gopi Jana Balava. Gopi Margaret in the Pullakudalai vaasikkum kaatchiyai avar kaanvaar.
Okay. Hare Krishna. Okay, we'll stop here.
Hare Krishna. Yuvraja Khan ki
jai.
Bhishma Maharaj ki
jai.
Bhishma Maharaj vartaman good pastime Radha Krishna. You are talking at here as Bhishma Maharaj gave us a very deep meaning of relationship. So we like to keep a very big thankful feeling. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Thank you, Maharaj, for coming and making this. So, important another month. Tomorrow is Krishna Balaram Jagannath Day. Fasting pilgrimage. And then please try to come and have a program here.